Who is this?
My name is Taylor Seal, sir, the manager.
Yeah, you the manager of that Celebrity Theater down there?
No, sir.
Well, or the Roy Clark Theater?
I'm the manager of the theater, sir.
Yeah, well, listen, I tell you what. My name is Roy D. Mercer. We drove up there from Bartlesville.
Uh-huh.
I sent my... What is this so damn funny? I sent my little stepdaughter and my son down there, Raymond and little teacher down there last night, and we had a problem with one of y'all's bartenders. I think his name was Chuck down there. Yeah, little Leticia, she had her a couple of beers over there, and she ran out of money, and the bartender said if she'd open a couple of buttons on her shirt, he'd give her free beer all night. And it ain't funny. And I tell you what, we got two ways to deal with this.
Okay.
You can either get Roy on the phone and apologize to me personally,
uh-huh.
or I'm coming down there and having to whoop somebody's ass.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You know, she's full grown and haired over, and she can do all of that drinking she wants to down there, and she can unbutton her shirt forever she wants to, Taylor.
Mm-hmm.
But I tell you what, she got drunker than Tootie Brown down there, and she come back to the motel.
Mm-hmm.
She commenced to getting sick.
Mm-hmm.
You ever see what Hawaiian punch and draft beer and a biggie fry will do to motel drapes?
Yes, sir. Sure have.
Well, we got a mess on our hands down here.
I can understand that.
Well, I want it took care of.
Okay. Well, what do you suggest, sir? First of all, Mr. Clark is not here right now.
Well...
So what do you suggest, sir?
Well, I suggested there may be an ass-whooping involved
mm-hmm.
there.
Okay.
Are you down there all day?
Me?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Well, you ever had an ass-whooping?
Not yet.
How big an old boy are you?
Oh, I'm just a little old thing, sir. I'm about 5'2", weigh about 130 pounds.
Yeah? You ever had somebody try to come over and play the whoop-ass cannonball on your face?
No, don't believe so, sir.
I'll be on you like ugly on an ape. I tell you what, I sent my little daughter, stepdaughter down there and my son down there to have a good time. They could have gone over to Nita Bryan's or they could have gone down to Mickey Gillies, but they wanted to go see Roy.
Well, Anita Bryan is, that would have been tough, sir. She's in Eureka Springs, and Mr. Gilley's theater is burnt to the ground. It's all the way down to the ground right this second. But that's okay. We appreciate her coming by here. She saw a great show.
Well, she did. She said she did, but she got pretty drunk down there.
Mm-hmm.
I guarantee you, I got $65 worth of drapes I got to get took care of, too.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a little bit of matter, and I ain't sure whether the dry cleaning will take it out, but I got an Ozark quilt that my wife, Sharon Jean, bought at one of them curio shops, and we got a mess on it, too.
Mm-hmm.
So what I need to do is get some money out of y'all or get some free tickets or there'd be an ass whooping.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, whichever one of those three you suggest, sir.
Well, my God,
I'm with you. Whichever one you want
to
do.
It ain't nothing for me to whoop a man's ass.
Okay. Well, like I said, sir, I'm just a little old man. I'm about 5'2" and weigh about 130 pounds. That's on one side of me. On the other side, I weigh a little bit more than that.
Y'all let your bartenders make rude comments to healthy little girls that come down there?
No, not really. All the girls in the Ozarks that come down here are all healthy looking, so we can't tell them apart.
Well, she's pretty proud of what Mother Nature done for her.
I'm sure she has, sir.
She wasn't too ashamed to show it off, but I guarantee you I don't allow that kind of stuff to go on in my household.
Well, did you teach her how to do these things, sir?
What are you suggesting?
You're talking about, how proud you are of what Mother Nature did for her body and everything.
I said she was proud of it.
I thought you said you were.
Now you're being a smartass. I'm going to put something on you that Babo won't take off, Mr. Taylor.
I hear you.
Yeah, I guarantee you. You better set aside about 2 hours this afternoon.
You better bring a lunch with you, sir.
I ain't going to need a lunch. All I'm going to need is maybe a ho-ho or a ding-dong.
A ho-ho or a ding-dong?
It ain't going to take a whole lunch down there. I tell you what, though, I might be willing to call the whole thing off if you give me some free tickets.
Sir, I tell you what. With this show that Roy does, and it is a great show. It's probably the best show in Branson.
Well, maybe.
You don't mind if I do a 60-second commercial here, do you?
I don't give a damn what you do. I just want some tickets for come down there and get some tickets for Phil and Brent.
Who the hell do you think this is?
It's Roy D. Mercer.
Maybe.
I've heard the tapes.
Back at us. it's kind of a boomerang effect there. What it was, by God.
Yeah, go ahead and do your 60-second commercial, Emmett.
Well, I tell you what, just tell everybody to come on up to Branson. It's a great time to come to Branson.
Would Jim Stafford peep down my shirt if I wanted him to?
He'll throw a cow patty on you.
He'd throw a cow patty on me. Well, I've had that happen before. I was a rodeo clown. You didn't know that, Taylor, before I went into ass whoop business.